Assalamu alaikum friends, hope sure you all good. This is Saeed Khan. In this video I'm gonna show you how you can easily identify structural breaks in your time series data. So as first of all, I would like to explain what is structural break. Structural breaks mean a sudden change in your data. So unexpected shift in your microeconomic time series is known as a structural breaks. Now the question arises, why we have a need to identify structural breaks? Because of we want to know about either our parameters are stable or not. Because of instability in parameters may lead toward unexpected signs. So I would like to suggest you please read these lines carefully. I have copied from Rob blog. I think awesome lines for the understanding of structural breaks. Hey guys, because I'm going to use eviews 9. So according to eviews, I have two tests, a chore breakpoint test and a second is a multiple breakpoint test. So what is chore breakpoint test? This test is used when we already know about the breakpoints. If I know that in 2003 there is a structural break because of there was some and specific incidents took place, because I know the time was not so good and there was a happening in that time, so I know. So in this case may I use breakpoint test, and further on the base of chow breakpoint test we can identify only single break in our series. I can identify only one breakpoint, even either there exists maybe 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But on the base of this test, I just can identify only single break. Now, multiple breakpoint test. This test is efficiently used when we have to find out more than single breakpoints. Suppose this test identify a maximum 5 breakpoint in our time series. And further, this test can be applied when we don't know already about the breakpoint in our data. Suppose I have a series of inflation, I don't know where is the breakpoint. So in this case, I can apply multiple breakpoint test. Hey guys, what is the cure of multiple breakpoints? Means if I have a break in my data, what is the cure of these breaks? So simple cure is, please add dummy variable. Suppose I have found 2 breakpoints in my series, so I have to add two dummy variables. So is there any disadvantages of adding dummy variables in series? According to this author, if we have a small sample size and to adding too much dummy variables, it may lead toward wrong signs, means unexpected results from the model. So if you have a large sample size, you can add too much dummy variables, but if you have a small sample size, you must apply very few dummies. So guys, how to test and breakpoint in eviews? Here I have my data. I have different variable A, B, D, O, 1 and H. E also my variable. So I want to check structural break in my A variable. So first of all, run a regression. Go to quick estimate, write your variable, then coefficient C, then okay. Results of my regression, go to view, stability diagnostic, and then because I don't know about breakpoints in data, so I cannot use chore test. So for unknown breaks, I must go for multiple breakpoint test. So guys, we have 5 methods. You can select anyone, all are equal efficient. So I would like to suggest first one. Here you can read detail about 5 methods. Here I have detail about 5 methods, so you can read. And further, I have also this option portion. Maximum 5 breaks, you can find out maximum 5 breaks and a level of 0.05% allow cross, you must cross allow. And now, see here, for option, please you can read further all the options. Read here. Hey guys, suppose I check and okay. You can see I have two break in my data. First one is 1982 and 1990. So I have two break. Suppose I want to check break in my whole model. So please select your all variables. Suppose A, B, D, O, 1, N, H. Okay. Open S equation. Okay. Yeah. Go to stability. Multiple break points because I don't know about the exact breaks. Okay. And cross. And okay. Hey guys, you can see I have only one break in our model. 1976 year is that year in which I have a break in my series. So what is cure? So for this year I have to add a dummy variable. As I have already a dummy variable, look here, my break point year was 1976. So before 1976, please put 0 for all years. So as I have put till 1975 0, and from exact 1976, because 1976 is my breakpoint test breakpoint year, so after this put 1 for whole years till 2014. Hey friends, now again run your model including dummy variable A, B, D, O, 1, H, N, including dummy also. Run open as equation. Okay, you can see your dummy variable is not significant. So whenever your dummy variable is not significant, you have no need to add your dummy variable in your actual model. Suppose I want to run VCM, ARDL or whatever, so I have no need to add this dummy variable for breakpoint 1976 because of this variable is not affecting model significantly. Hey guys, normally arise question. Suppose I have checked individually breakpoint in variable A, I found 2, in variable B, I found 2 structural break, in variable D, 1, I found 2 structural breaks, means I found total 6 breaks in my whole variables. So what to do now? Please add 6 dummies and run again your regression as I have run, and see what are the significant dummies. The significant dummies you must add in your actual model, and the dummies which are not significant you have no need to add in your actual model. Suppose you want to run VECM and you find 3 variables are significantly affecting your model. So add 3 variables which are significantly affecting your model in your VECM model. So hope sure you enjoyed. Thank you so much.